On the latest episode of the Wizards Tip Off podcast, point guard Tim Frazier joined the show to talk about his first few days with the team. Frazier told the story behind him and Jody Meeks living in the same building and why he is spending a lot of time at Meeks' place. Frazier also described his game and personality as Wizards fans get to know him. You can listen to the episode right here. You can download the podcast on Apple Podcasts right here and on Google Play. If you like the show, please tell your friends. Related 10 questions with Bradley Beal. Scroll down for more Wizards stories. Wizards guard John Wall has never been afraid to share his personal goals, even knowing things can be taken out of context and used to set expectations in the minds of many. Some athletes shy away from proclamations, knowing they will be held to them. This off-season Wall already threw it out there. He wants to make first-team all-defense for the 201,718 season. And now he's talking about winning the NBA's Most Valuable Player award. Actually, it was his head coach Scott Brooks who got it all started on Media Day last week. John Wall is one of the best players in basketball, Brooks said. I think now you can really talk about him being in the MVP conversation. He has that type of ability. He has that type of game. When asked about Brooks' quote, Wall didn't walk it back or beat around the bush. That's not his style. Related Otto Porter on hanging with J. Cole. It's a goal that I have for myself. Also, he said, it's not more pressure. It's an opportunity knowing how much I worked on my game. It shows how much coach believes in me. He wants me to run the team. He's put me in different positions to excel. That's my ultimate goal, to be MVP one day. Why not have it have an MVP season this year? Earning the MVP these days is about as difficult as it has ever been in the NBA. Last season, Oklahoma City Thunder star Russell Westbrook took home the honors by setting an NBA record for triple-doubles. He was the first player to average a triple-double since Oscar Robertson in 196,162. Rockets guard James Harden finished second and he had one of the best seasons in league history with an absurd line of 29.1 points and 11.2 assists per game. The NBA's MVP award was so competitive last year that LeBron James finished fourth despite setting career highs in rebounds and assists and helped lead the Cavs while Kevin Love missed a quarter of the season. Wall was just the second player in NBA history to average at least 23 points, 10 assists and 2 steals while shooting over 45% from the field in a season, and he wasn't even a finalist. Related OUBRERCOKS Barack Obama pants now. Last year was unusual in the annals of the NBA. Not since 197,273 had a player averaged at least 29 points and 10 assists in one season, and both Harden and Westbrook did so in 201,617. Those are tough numbers to compete with, especially for a point guard like Wall who is directly compared to them. If history is any indication, Wall will have to score more to leap into the MVP mix. His 23.1 points last season were excellent and enough to tie Bradley Beal for the lead on the Wizards. But no MVP has held a scoring average that low since Steve Nash in 200,506, the only MVP to score less than 25 per game since Nash was Stephen Curry in 201,415, but he had a 59.4 effective field goal percentage and led the best team in the NBA. In theory, Nash's path to the MVP, he won it twice, is probably the best blueprint for Wall. Nash took home the award with seasons of 15.5 points and 11.5 assists, 200,405 and 18.8 points and 10.5 assists, 200,506 per game. Wall puts up those type of numbers on a regular basis, but much has changed about the point guard position since Nash's heyday. Now the top point guards are often the number one scoring options on their teams, and scoring is a big determinant of postseason awards. With everything Wall already does, between passing, rebounding and racking up steals, adding a few more points per game is what it will probably require to get his name into the MVP mix. An argument could be made he should have been in the discussion this past season, but as history shows, it's scoring that reigns supreme, especially for point guards these days. Related NEWE newest WIZARDSJOINS The Tip Off podcast. John Wall, Bradley Beal and the Washington Wizards battle Tyler Hansbrough and the Guangzhou Longlians of the Chinese Basketball Association on Monday night. Here is all you need to know. TV, live stream and radio info, tip-off time, plus 3 things to watch. Wangzhou Longlins at Washington Wizards where Capital One Arena at Yipof 7:00 p.m. ETTV non-alive stream Monumental Sports Radio None 3 Things to Watch. New Year, New Team Monday night will offer the first real extended look at the Wizards' newest players after an off-season that saw them overhaul their bench. Though point guard Tim Frazier, their most notable acquisition, won't play, this will give everyone a glimpse at shooting guard Jody Meeks and forward Mike Scott. With Frazier likely to miss the game due to a grade 1 groin strain, expect camp invite Donald Sloan and second-year pro Thomas Satoransky to play plenty at point guard. Center Ian Mahinmi should be interesting to watch after he lost 10 pounds this summer. He worked tirelessly to trim down in hopes of being more mobile this year and taking weight off his surgically repaired knees. There's also Carrick Felix, who won the team's dunk contest on Friday night and offers potential on the defensive end. He could push Sheldon Mack for his roster spot as a backup shooting guard. And rookie Mike Young should get some run with their other two-way player, Devin Robinson, sidelined due to a stress fracture in his left foot. Related Otto Porter on hanging with J. Cole replacing Morris. The biggest objective for the Wizards this preseason is figuring out what they will do with Markieff if Morris likely out the first few weeks of the regular season. With Morris recovering from sports hernia surgery, the Wizards need to explore their options. Those options should include Scott, who is capable at the 4 position, Jason Smith and Otto Porter. Though Porter has been penciled in as their starting small forward for years now, head coach Scott Brooks could opt to go small and play him at power forward with Kelly Oubre Jr. alongside him at the 3. On the outside looking in would be Chris McCullough and Young. McCullough impressed during training camp, according to Brooks, and offers lots of potential at 6'11" with speed, the ability to play above the rim and a smooth jumper. Young is expected to play most of his time in the league this year, but don't tell that to him. His goal is to make the roster and he does play power forward. Plus, the Wizards are high on his future so don't rule out him making things interesting for them. Related how Mahinmi lost weight, why he loves DC Psycho T. Given the Longlins play ball in China, there are going to be a lot of names Wizards fans will not recognize. They do, however, have one very famous player, Tyler Hansborough, the former University of North Carolina star who is arguably one of the best college basketball players in history. He finished his career as one of the most decorated Tar Heels ever and that is saying something. Hansborough HASNT played in the NBA since 2016 when he was with the Charlotte Hornets, but is only 31 and he did technically tear up the league then the D-League last season. If we know anything about Hansborough from his playing days in the US is that he gives crazy effort on a nightly basis, hence his nickname. And given this is an opportunity for him to play against NBA competition, it would make sense if he will want to do his best to impress whichever scouts are paying attention. Related Kelly Oubre can see why Durant made a fake Twitter account.